The devil is still near. He behaves much the same as before as he does here. I saw him as a blue boar and a skipping deer. He lent his name to rocks, caves, glen, and even beer. He lost my trail when I threw him down into the deep chasm at Middletown. I took off running through the willows. He missed me thrice at Devil's Den, Devil's Bridge, and Devil's Head and Pillows. He somehow found me on the Devil's Ash Heap. I don't know if he took a boat or swam the deep. I didn't want him to take back the deal we had made, cause neither man nor devil got the better of me in a trade. We had first met many years ago. He was dressed in black velvet from top to toe. I spotted the stranger as I chatted with Dougie, wearing handsome black boots and cane and black buggy. I had seen him before he saw me, so I crept up to the house he had entered to see. Not usually a peeping Tom I would be, but he had flown to the roof and right down the chimney. It was General John Moulton who lived in the house, his only companion, a small kitchen mouse. Riches for his soul, he trade, John declared. Think of the devil when the devil is there. Out of the chimney came a sparks in the shower. In a black velvet suit stood the dark power. Your servant general, no need to cower. But I'm expected at the governor's in quarter an hour, so let's make haste, if you please. The general now rose from down on his knees. 15 minutes for a trip of 5 leagues. Then you must be...
Shh! What signifies a name? Interrupted the stranger, with a deprecating wave of the hand. Come, do we understand each other? Is it a bargain or not?
Now I thought this show was getting pretty good. I made myself a makeshift chair from a piece of wood. I got out my tobacco and I packed up a bowl. How often do you get to see some sinner try and sell his soul?
At the Talmud's backward bargain, the general pricked up his ears. I could out-trade the devil, he had boasted for years. He took out his jackknife and began to whittle. The devil took out his and pared down his nails a little. What proof have I that you can open riches' door? The devil snapped his fingers, gold coins fell to the floor. The general grabbed the coin and dropped it, cause it was hot. The devil laughs and tried again, but John stood in his spot. The devil said, don't be afraid, general touched the gold. Spurred it first, but picked it up cause the coin was cold. He rung it on the table and weighed it in his hand. It was full weight and had the truest ring in the land. Then back to business, by the way, have you anything to drink? There's some old Jamaica in the cupboard by the sink. Excellent, I'm as thirsty as a Puritan on election day. The general poured the rum and they had a toast.
Satan smacked his lips for a while. John asked, don't you find it to your style? He ventured to ask, went out on a limb. He thought he might get the devil drunk and outwit him. I've drunk worse, but let me show you how.
To make a salamander, replied Satan, and
pow! 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 Pow!
He took one
pow.
He took one of the candles to his glass of rum. A spectral blue flame burst out as bright as the sun.
The fiend raised his glass up to his eye, and John saw a fiery lizard's tongue, tail, and eye. To our better acquaintance, the devil drank it down. He tipped the bottle 5 more times and drank the contents down. Now that you are convinced, I can make you the richest in the town. I've got the parchment, you only have to write your name down. I engage
engage on my part to fill up both your boots on the first of every month with gold, jewels, and loot. But mark me well, if you try to play me any trick, you'll repent it with much more pain than this finger prick. I know you, John Moulton, so please take every care. I shall keep my eye upon you, so beware.
Signed!
John drank his rum, so many names he did see. The highest personage is on the list, he'd be in good company. He signed and Satan said, good, rely on me. Satan stood and flew right back out his chimney.